Hi, I'm Lochie Daddo for the National Maritime Museum in Sydney. Now, I don't know about you, but I've often thought there's got to be an easier way to clean my sub. It just takes the kids too long on a weekend. So I thought I'd come and have a chat to the experts, and I'm with Phil McKendrick, the fleet manager at the National Maritime Museum. He's in charge of 14 vessels here, including this, the HMAS Onslow. How often do you have to go through the process of cleaning them?
Well, the process of cleaning is done every 3 years. It's taken over to the dockyard and docked and given a clean and a spruce up.
Phil, so how do we know when a sub is sub-standard?
That's very good. That's a very good question. So we do inspections on the hull of the submarine. We have marine divers in the museum. And that's how we know it's substandard.
But it's not like the sub's out and about, so why is it necessary?
No, that's true. It is good food for the fish, but it tends to, the marine growth breaks down the coating, the paint scheme on the bottom of the ship, and it can cause rust and corrosion.
So tell us, what's going to happen?
We're now in transit to go to Talis at Garden Island, and we'll take it into the outer Captain Cook dry dock. And then we'll dock down the submarine onto blocks, empty out the dock, pump out the water, and then we'll start to hydroblast the underwater side of the vessel. So really, you can only see so much from the water, but once it's dry, you'll be able to see a lot of the growth, and then we can determine how long it'll take, but approximately 2 to 3 days.
From a car wash point of view, I pay $2 for 2 minutes to spray down my car. What are we paying for this sort of
project? You could probably multiply that by a couple of thousand, I think. The price to dock it down and get the hydroblast done is $120,000. Well, here we are at Talis Dockyard, Garden Island, and the submarine now sitting on the blocks in the outer Captain Cook dock. And now we're in the process of cleaning the submarine. They've got high pressure water blasters, and they run at about 3,000 to 5,000 PSI. But it really depends on the extent of the marine growth on the vessel at what pressure they set. So they've got to set those machines up to remove the marine growth and the rust on the vessel's hull. Well, what happens, the marine growth breaks down the paint scheme on the steel hull, and that can cause corrosion and also breach the watertight integrity of the vessel. So it's very important that these are done every 3 to 4 years to protect the vessel's steel hull. Well, it's not typically like your car. It takes 2 days to clean the hull of the vessel, and then over the next 10 days we'll be doing a survey of the submarine's hull with our fleet surveyor, Warwick, Thomson.
We need to know firstly how our anti-foul paint systems work and what problems there are, so that we can have good interaction with the paint manufacturer to solve any problems.
We use the paint that the Navy use on their submarines, but it's stealth black, so you know, you can't see me, and that's what the submarine's all about, not to be detected. But it's an international paint, but it's a Navy paint scheme, so we follow the guidelines that the Navy use on their submarines that are in commission today.
Well, that was a blast. Okay, so let's have a look at what's involved. Always get a scuba diver to check the hull condition. Make sure your sub is ready for the open water. Get it to a dry dock. Then make sure, now this is important, make sure you blast the gunk while it's still wet. Otherwise, you'll never get it off. And finally, have an open checkbook. This is not a cheap process. Really, it makes washing the car on the weekend a walk in the park, doesn't it?